you can without doing all these things, simply what you can do here is you can give NN start. Once if you give NN start, automatically the neural network toolbox gets opened. I think it's taking time. So now see here, it will open a neural network toolbox here. And if you want curve fitting or clustering or regression, you can choose accordingly. So if it is for pattern recognition and classification, you just click on the pattern recognition app. So it will get into that app. Okay. So it's a two-layer feedforward network with the sigmoid hidden and softmax layer. So you can also customize that design. Okay, if you want. So here, just I'm going for loading the example data set. So let us consider here, and so you have, as Madam said, we have iris flowers here. So let us consider this iris flower. So see here, we have taken the attributes. That is four attributes here, four features. Sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width. Okay, so these are the four features that are being taken here, the features, the attributes for the classification. Okay, and then import it. So now, after importing it, you can go to the next step. Now see here, the training by default always of 70%. So randomly 150 samples are taken, and out of the 150 samples, 104 samples are being fixed for training. And for validation, you can vary it. Okay, so you can have any number of the percentage here. Let us consider it's 10%. So accordingly, see here, the training samples will get increased. Okay, so once if I increase the testing percentage, now see here, 105 samples for training and 15 samples for validation, and then 30 samples for testing. So training is to train the network. Okay, and validation is nothing but these are used to measure network generalization. Okay, when to stop the training. So that is being decided by this validation. Okay, to halt training when generalization stops improving. So testing, no effect on training. So it is an independent measure of the network performance. Okay, and then once if you fix the number of samples here, okay, you can go for deciding the number of neurons, hidden neurons. Okay, and since this pattern net is defined, already defined network, you have one hidden layer, one output layer. You can vary the number of neurons here. If you want, you can increase the number of neurons in that hidden layer. If you increase the number of neurons, the computation gets varied. The computation difficulty will increase, but the results will be better. Okay. And after fixing the number of hidden neurons, go for training. Okay. So once if you train it, so it will get trained. Once if you are satisfied with the training, okay, so you can go for plotting the confusion matrix. I think confusion matrix is not. Enough after you can save the results. Okay, so here if you want, you can give your own data set here. I think a confusion matrix is not generated. I don't know why, but so this is how you can train your networks. Enough, see here, see, even you can have confusion matrix.